Hello friends, welcome to the session on communication electronics. In this session, we'll be discussing about pulse code modulation. In this session, we will see what we mean by pulse code modulation. We will see the block diagram of PCM transmitter, and we will see the various processes that are involved in PCM transmission, such as quantization, sampling, and encoding. Friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, Learn with Prakash Khanal, and subscribe to the channel to see more videos on the subjects of electronics and computer science. So let us start the session with the question, what we mean by pulse code modulation. In pulse modulation, we know that the modulating signal is a continuous signal and the carrier signal is in the form of square pulses. Pulse code modulation is a digital modulation technique. Earlier modulation technique that we have discussed, such as PAM, PWM, and PPM, are the analog modulation technique. But pulse code modulation is a digital modulation technique. In pulse code modulation, a sequence of binary code is being transmitted, and this sequence of binary code is in accordance with the amplitude of the modulating signal. In PCM transmission, you will find that there are three main processes involved, such as sampling, quantization, and encoding. PCM is a very powerful technique, and it is a digital technique. And therefore, you will find that it is possible that whenever we use the PCM, then the several digital signals can be multiplexed. That is, several digital signals can be transmitted on the same channel. PCM is a technique which do not require any kind of synchronization between transmitter and receiver. As we have seen in PPM, the synchronization is being required, but in PCM, we do not require any synchronization. PCM is a digital technique where the binary code is being transmitted, and therefore, in this technique, the noise can be easily separated from the required PCM signal. PCM is a powerful technique, and you will find that this technique can be used even for the space communication. That is, whenever we want to transmit a signal from the space satellite to the Earth, then you know that this is very a long distance, and still it is possible that you can transmit the signal by using the PCM. PCM is also used in wide variety of applications. Say, for example, in digital telephony, we can make the use of PCM. Also, whenever we want to transmit the digital audio or a digital video, then the PCM technique can be used. Of course, the PCM technique is a digital technique, and any digital technique will require larger bandwidth than that of the analog techniques. So this is a kind of a drawback that in PCM, it will require larger bandwidth than that of pulse amplitude modulation. But the biggest advantage with the PCM is that in PCM, the binary code is being transmitted, and therefore it has a good noise immunity. In PCM, the transmitted power that is being required is very, very low, and it is also not variable. Since the transmitted power requirement is very low, this is the reason this modulation technique is being used for the space communication, where the signal can travel a very large distance. Now let us go for understanding the block diagram of PCM transmitter. This is the block diagram of PCM transmitter. The first block is a source of the message signal. This message signal is connected to a low pass filter circuit where the cutoff frequency is equal to the modulating signal frequency. The output of the low pass filter is connected to a sampler circuit. To the same sampler circuit, the sampling signal FS is also connected. So for the generation of sampling signal, some timer circuit is being used where the FS is always kept greater than or equal to twice FM so that the sampling theorem is satisfied. The output of the sampler is a PAM signal which is connected to the next block, and this block is being called as a quantizer. The output of the quantizer is further connected to the encoder, and the output of the encoder is being connected to the parallel to serial converter, so that we can have a serial output, and this output is just nothing but the PCM output. The analog signal, which is a modulating signal, is passed through a band limiting low pass filter, and this filter circuit will have a cutoff frequency fc is equal to fm, so that all unwanted frequencies will be rejected by this filter circuit. The output of the filter circuit is connected to the sampler circuit, and to the same sampler circuit we will connect the sampling frequency fs. As we know that sampling is a process where the samples of the analog signal are obtained at a given interval of time, such that the sampling frequency fs should be greater than or equal to twice fm. So this is the Nyquist criteria that should be followed whenever we make the use of the sampling. The output of the sampler, you will find that it is a pulse amplitude modulation signal or PAM signal, and it is further connected to a block, and this block is being called as a quantizer. Now let us go for understanding the process of quantization. Quantizer will perform the job of quantization. Quantization is the process of assigning analog samples a predetermined discrete level. So during the quantization, the PAM signal is being converted into a discrete level signal. The number of quantization levels will depend upon the number of bits per sample n that are used to code the signal. So during the quantization, you will find that the PM signal is being converted into a step signal. The number of levels L will depend upon the N, and the relation between L and N can be given as L is equal to 2 raised to N, where L will stand for number of levels and N will stand for the number of bits per sample. The magnitude of the minimum step size in the quantization, it is being called as a resolution. And for this resolution, we will make the use of the symbol delta V. So as shown in this diagram, you will find that the step size is being called as a resolution, delta V. The resolution will depend upon the maximum voltage Vmax and the minimum voltage Vmin. So we can write a formula for the resolution as delta V is equal to Vmax minus Vmin divided by L minus 1. So the step size should be small, that is the resolution should be as small as possible. Then you will find that the error that is being introduced during the process of quantization will be much less. But if you want to reduce this delta V, then you need to increase L. But if you need to increase L, then the number of the bits per sample will also increase, and it will increase the bandwidth of the communication system. So quantization error is the distortion that is being introduced in the quantization process when the modulating signal is not the exact value of the quantization level. So you will find that in the quantization process, the value of the modulating voltage is being converted into a discrete level. So certain group of values are being assigned the same value, and therefore in the quantization, some kind of error is being introduced, and this error is being called as the quantization error. The maximum quantization error that can be given as QV is equal to plus or minus delta V upon 2. So the quantization error will depend upon the resolution delta V. And if the resolution is less, then the quantization error will also be less. So quantization error can be reduced by increasing the number of levels. But if you want to increase the number of levels, then it will require the larger bandwidth, because the number of the bits per sample will go on increasing, and therefore it will require more bandwidth to transmit the same signal. Now we will go for the process of encoding. Encoding is the process of assigning n bit digital word for each level. You can say that encoder is basically an analog to digital converter. So an AD converter can be used as an encoder. We know that the relationship between L and N, N can be written as log of L to the base 2, or L is equal to 2 raised to N. So for example, if we have a 3-bit PCM, that is when the number of bits N is equal to 3, then there can be 8 levels. That is, when N is equal to 3, then L is equal to 2 raised to 3, that is equal to 8 levels. So for example, as shown in this table, suppose there are 8 levels, quantization level from 1 to 8. Then for each level, we can assign a binary number. So for level 1, the binary number will be 000. And the corresponding pulse waveform will be a flat 1. For level 2, the binary number will be 001. And the corresponding pulse will have a maximum amplitude only at the third stage. Then if the quantization level is 3, then the binary number will be 010. For 4, it will be 011. For 5, it will be 100. For 6, it will be 101. For 7, it will be 110. And for the level 8, the corresponding binary number will be 111. So you will find that all such binary numbers can have a pulse waveform as shown in this diagram. So every level can be assigned a 3-bit binary number starting from 000 to 111. You will find that the output of the encoder is being converted into a stream of the pulses by using a parallel to serial converter. So whenever we want to obtain only one serial output, then we need to make the use of parallel to serial converter to obtain the 1-bit at a time output. So we can say that the output of the PCM transmitter will be a train of the digital pulses. Now this is a complete diagram which will show us how the signal is being transformed from one stage to another stage. So the first diagram will represent the input signal, which is a continuous signal. And the second, in the second diagram, we have the sampling pulses. When the input signal and the sampling pulses are applied to the sampler, then at the output of the sampler, we will get the PM signal. This signal is being called as a sampled signal. So you will find that the amplitude of the pulses will go on changing as per the amplitude of the modulating signal. When this signal is applied to the quantizer, then at the output of the quantizer, we will get a quantized signal. So you will find that this PM signal is being converted into a discrete signal. You will find that a step signal is being obtained at the output of the quantizer. And then finally, every step is being assigned a binary code, and this code will be available at the PCM signal or PCM code at the output of the transmitter. So thank you friends for viewing the session. Hopefully you have understood how PCM transmitter works. In our next session, we will discuss the PCM receiver. Thank you for viewing the session.